What was the person's name? Galtis Gavron. Okay. Galtis, no. Oh, yes, of course. Look at you.
How may I help you?
I'm fine, thank you. What can I do for you? You always know someone's very suspicious when all they're selling are ash statues! No. I mean, that is very suspicious. But, when they have very few lines that you can ask them about. Oh, he's so pissed! What? Ash statue? How could you? No, never mind. I'll just have to take care of this right now. Oh shit, how could I look at his statues? God, I'm such an Enwa looking at his statues! Hey gang, what's good? Welcome back to another Morrowind Mondays. Well, you can see I've cleared out, as promised, all of the ebony armor that we looted. I actually sold it to this guy.
Traveler.
I didn't go to any special merchant with a lot of gold. In fact, this guy, he's only got 700. Well, he did have 700, but I haven't waited a day yet. I just waited multiple days, and I bought a whole bunch of his stuff, which is why you see he has large amounts of hammers. See, he's got like hundreds of them, and all these things. He's got a lot of all of his regenerating, replenishing items. He's got a whole lot of it because, well, I every time I just bought out more and more of his stuff. But it got us up to almost 25k, which is pretty great. I cooked up some potions and I sold ingredients to folks at the temple, and I bought their replenishing restore health potions, filled up on those. Their health potions are pretty awful. They only restore 2 or 1 point for 5 seconds. Pretty bad, but it's all we've got really to work with for the time being. Anyways, I thought that first and foremost we should go to Aldrun and get our manor going, because it takes time to create it, to get it going. And I figured, hey,
where would you like
that'd be a great thing to do while we're going to Shishi. And then also it'll help me not spend the money on stupid shit. So we could have had way more money if we went to specific merchants, but I don't know. I feel like, especially there's two merchants who have a whole lot of money. And I feel like it's kind of in poor taste to go to those merchants when we haven't even discovered them in the playthrough. I don't know. Not into that. So I just used that guy right in front of me. Not efficient, but gets the job done. I don't think we'll have many problems with money anyways. Especially since we're like mid-level now. Yeah, we're getting up there. We're not mid-level, but we're getting up there. We've got a level in the bank. Could stand to do some training. Maybe we'll do that at the end of this one, in between. Especially since we have so much money. See, look, I already want to spend it all. Oh gosh, I cannot remember the name of the woman who does the
is there something I can do
the manor work, but I remember about where she is. It was like Garissa, something like that. Oh, and I repaired up all of our stuff. I even bought a couple spells. I bought an Elmsevi intervention spell. Pretty good. And I think I bought a sanctuary spell that way I could just have that on me.
You have my attention.
What did I do to deserve this honor?
I think it's in here, right? Hopefully. Council Hall. I think it was toward the left. It was like at a big junction. Maybe this was it. Practice room? No, I don't think that's it. Could be some good weapons in there. Maybe this was it. No. No. I mean, I'm kind of curious what this person sells, though. Oh, you're not the... Oh.
You have my attention, Outlander.
What do you actually have? Wow, Grandmaster Armor Hammers. Okay. But really nothing of interest. God, I love how the bone mold armor works. Or looks.
She has 2k gold, though.
Maybe I should have sold to her instead, huh?
Okay. Let's check in here. Trader, no. Maybe this is her up here. I mean, we can actually check the map. Oh, yeah, Galissa Gindu. I remember the alliteration in her name. Okay. Construction contract. Okay, yep. Yep, the stronghold. Yep, I have the 5,000 drakes. Do I have the construction contract? I can't remember if I had gotten that. Let's just say I got it. No, I do not. Okay, so we need to go to Ebonheart.
You have
right.
My attention,
I thought we could have just given her the money first and then go get that. So let's head to Ebonheart, which is a nice little place to go to.
I suppose there's no harm.
Ebonheart isn't too far off. Let's see, how could we get there? We can take a Siltstrider to Vivek. I think is Vivek is the... It's not the capital of Morrowind. That's Morrowind, the City of Light, City of Magic. But does Vardenfell, the Vardenfell region, have a capital? If not, then it's the largest city in Vardenfell. Because Vardenfell is the island, if you're unfamiliar with all that. Morrowind actually consists of the island and surrounding islands as well, and the mainland area, which kind of envelops Vardenfell. Oh, look at that. We should maybe jump some more. Acrobatics is agility, right? Yeah, I believe so. Because I don't think it would be speed. I don't know why there were goats there. Did you just hear that? Those were goats, right? Okay, so we can go to Balmora, and then from Balmora we can go to Vivek, and then we can walk to Ebonheart from Vivek.
We make a special trip.
I really hope the Duke doesn't want us to do some bullshit, back. Too. I can't remember how that goes. Maybe he'll be like, oh, there's a lot of Gwars terrorizing the local villagers. The local farms are stamping on everybody's stuff. I'm really messing the place up. Let's wait until day. Okay. About 9 hours. Should be dawn. Yeah. Wow, looks really nice. Okay. Ebonheart should be... I can't remember if it's southeast or southwest. Alright, yeah, southeast. So we'll walk all the way over there. It's worth it. This manor is going to be worth it. I'm telling you. It's going to be great. It's going to be good. It's going to be great. Yeah, Vivek is pretty huge city. It's very, I don't know what you would call it. I think I've referenced this before. It looks kind of like those Italian cities that are built so close to water and they have the water incorporated into them. What do those cities do when it floods anyways? That seems pretty dangerous, you know, now that I think of it. You know what cities I'm talking about? They use all the white rock as well. Gosh. Like Super Mario Sunshine, the main city, Delfino Plaza, was based off of those sorts of towns. Same goes for that one map in Overwatch, Ilios, I think it was. Wow, there really is a Gwar terrorizing the area. Take its Gwar hide. Oh shit, we are over encumbered. Yeah, look, I've got so many of these potions, they're weighing me down. Yeah, we don't really need Gwar hide. I forgot we were overweight, though. There we are. There's a Kagudi over there. But yeah, Vivek is pretty nice looking. The big issue, though, is that, of course, Morrowind is a pretty old game, so there's not many NPCs populating Vivek itself on the outside. Like, inside, there's a bunch of people hanging out and stuff. And, of course, like, obviously, without the mods installed, Vivek actually looks pretty god-awful. But hey, here it looks great. You got some textures going on. And I think it looked pretty nice in the Elder Scrolls Online Morrowind expansion, the little clips I've seen of it. I might have to get that just to go visit there. I don't know. Maybe save up money for that. I'll think about it. Something to keep in mind. Oh gosh. Oh my gosh. That would have been a fucking nightmare if we got stuck on that tree. Just some innocuous looking tree out in the middle of nowhere. Oh, and here we are. Speaking of Morrowind, for Elder Scrolls Online, there is the meteor, the chunk of rock. I think it's... If it's in midair, is it called a meteor or a meteorite? I think once it touches ground, it becomes a meteorite. Correct? And then what's a meteoroid? Shit, I don't even know. I don't remember. It's one of those three things. It hasn't touched the ground yet, but it is floating there. And I believe it is moving ever so slightly. Obviously, in the game, it's not moving because that'd be too hard to do. But I think there's a book that says that it is actually moving very slowly. But I, the idea is that the magic of the gods, the tribunal, is keeping it in place up there from crashing into Vivek. That's actually one of the things that occurs in a round, or slightly before Skyrim takes place. It actually, their magic wears off because the events of Morrowind have had effect, which we probably shouldn't go into until that occurs in the game. But yeah, it's just kind of like time is paused for it. It's still. So, like, it has the potential energy of a meteor falling, plummeting to the ground, but time is, like, stalled for it. So it's, like, slowly moving through time or something like that. I don't remember the specifics. But either way, when the spell wears off, it immediately crashes down and obliterates the entire area. It's pretty intense. Stupid hats. But, yeah, that's pretty crazy. They really go out of their way in Skyrim to completely fuck over Morrowind.
Let's hear it.
It's a little sad, honestly. You know, we are going to have one hell of a time finding the guy. I think he's over there in this huge castle. I can't remember for sure, though. The Duke. I remember as a kid playing this, it took me for freaking ever to find him. And there's several quests that involve speaking with him. Oh, and I remember I killed this guy because I liked his armor so much. I just taunted the crap out of him and killed him. As it turns out, kids have very little remorse. You're not the Duke. You aren't well-dressed enough. Where is the Duke? You definitely won't want to tell me. Do you know? Ebonheart. Kessel Ebonheart is the seat of the Imperial Authority on Vardenfell. Here, Duke Vadam Dren, Duke of Ebonheart, and the Vardenfell Grand Council determine law and policy for the Vardenfell Administrative District. The Imperial Cult Shrine here serves the Duke, but his retainers, and the castle's garrisons, I don't know why I put a butt in there. And is also an administrative center for the Imperial cult presence on Vardenfell. A unit of the Imperial Guard protects the Duke, and the Hawkmoth Legion is also garrisoned within the walls of the castle. Because the East Empire Company is chartered directly by the Emperor, its offices, warehouses, and docks are adjacent to the castle, and its security is assured by the Imperial garrisons. The provinces of Skyrim and Black Marsh maintain diplomatic missions within the walls of Castle Ebonheart to ensure that their political interests are respected by the laws and policies of the Duke and the Grand Council. Okay, let's ask about the Duke himself, Vadam Dren. Duke Vadam Dren, Duke of Ebonheart, is the head of the Grand Council and Uriel VII's representative on Vardenfell. Okay, But where is he? Good God, I can't remember. That leads to outdoors. Imperial Commission? No, I don't think so. In here? Maybe he's upstairs. Maybe. Well, shit! Well, what the fuck? God, I remember that. What terrible design is that? A stairway that goes to nowhere! Okay, let's see. Grand Council Chambers. Okay, this is surely it. Does this also go to nowhere? Oh, it doesn't. Look, but this might. Yep. That is so terrible. Gosh. I mean, you can't hold it against them too much because, you know, Morrowind's a pretty old game. They're still figuring things out. Here he is. Duke Vadam Dren. Look, he's got decked out in ebony armor. Lalam Dreddel and Varus Ventinius. Looking like a smug son of a bitch in his silvery armor.
Where is that slave?
The Duke's guard as well. Also wearing silvery armor. Just like him. Okay. Let's quick save before we talk to him in case we piss him off somehow. I am Vadam Dren, Duke of Vardenfell. Welcome to Ebonheart, Outlander. Okay. Construction contract. I'm not sure if I should issue you a contract. Vardenfell faces many threats today. I will grant you a contract if you vow to do what you can for my people. I vow that I will do what I can. That is good enough for me. Take this contract. Use your stronghold for the defense of my people, and as an aid in your fight against our enemies. Thanks. Well, that was pretty... Oh, shit! That was pretty easy, except for the part where we got over-encumbered by, like, 0.1. Let's drink a fatigue potion, I guess? Is that something we should do? I think that's something we should do. We could drop a probe. Oh my god, probes have a weight of 1 each. Apprentice probes? Yeah, let's drop them. My god! That's insane! Whew! Okay. How do we get out of here? Oh god, I didn't remember. Okay. Okay. Everything's fine. Everything's good. Right? Get out through here? It said Grand Council Chambers, but I'm hoping that's... I didn't just go in a circle. Oh, thank god. Okay. Here we are. What the fuck? Where the fuck are we? Oh my god. We're trapped! We've been bamboozled! Hopefully we can navigate through here to the bridge. Oh god. This is it, right? Oh, thank goodness. You know what? Let's mark it. Do we have something we can put down here? We don't need our fortify intelligence potions just yet. We can make more. We'll mark it with that. Cool. Now we'll always know that this is the way out.
Any time now.
Be good if we took some of these lanterns. Could use them.
You want something, friend?
Oh, this guy, his armor looks special because it's from the expansion, from Tribunal. He's one of the people who you have to talk to get out to Mournhold.
You've got my ear, let's hear it.
I have that man's ear. It's pretty gnarly. Alright, so now we just need to head all the way back to Alderaan. Take a quick jaunt through the wilderness. Of course... Ebonheart being an Empire-influenced little town. They've got a big dragon statue thing. Empire loves their dragons. But yeah, I think, I can't remember if it was the cause of it or what, but obviously in Skyrim you can look over from, the Dragonborn expansion when you're at Solstheim, you can look and see mainland Vardenfell. Or not, I guess it's not mainland, but you can see Vardenfell in Red Mountain. And you can see that it has erupted and is actually, like, shit is, like, fuming out of it. Like, ash is spewing forth. And I want to say that the impact of the meteor resulted in some of the... In like, seismic activity that caused the volcano to erupt. Either that, or it was, like... It was the Dunmer people getting completely fucked. Due to some sort of religious thing. Something like that. But, yeah. Pretty god-awful. It actually gives them... All the natural disasters that occur... Actually gives them pretty good reason to return to Morrowind sometime in the future. Maybe, like... I don't know. If rumors are true, Elder Scrolls 5... Or 6... Would be... In... Valenwood? Or... Project Greenheart? You know, you heard about that, Project Greenheart? Probably be in... Oh, gosh, this fish. Probably be... Rumors are that it's going to be in the Wood Elf area. But hey, they could have an expansion to that. A DLC returns you to Morrowind. But they probably wouldn't do that because Morrowind is so huge, unless it's just a small part. I don't know. Pretty interesting stuff, though. Almost there, huh? I don't believe there's any way to get directly to Ebonheart. You have to always go from Vivec and make the run. We could have actually used our speedy boots. I just didn't think to do it, and I got kind of sucked into talking. Okay. Gosh, you look awful. Let's go to... Balmora.
Where would you like to go?
And Alderaan.
Where would you like to go?
Great. Okay. We'll just do a quick little shortcut through the back end here, you know? Should really be doing this more often. Just the idea of the taking the road, I don't know. Appealing. Oh, look, the trauma route came back. Probably because I spent, like, a month waiting in front of that vendor. So that way he could get his money back. Spent, like, 24 hours each time. Yeah, it's kind of amazing how easily Duke Vidom Dren is just like, yeah, sure, the contract to build in this place, this godforsaken place. Sure, here, just have one. Just you better say that you're gonna be a good person. You gotta be a good person, or else we won't let you. I wonder if you have, like, a criminal bounty, or, if you... Oh, God, this is the wrong place. If you have infamy, if he'll let you do that. I don't know. Maybe he counts as a guard and you could turn yourself into him anyways. If you're if you have a outstanding bounty.
Is there something I can do for you?
Yes, there is. I'm here to discuss my stronghold. I have the money and the contract. This is adequate, Lyle. Your stronghold will be built in the Bal Isra on the road to Margon. Construction will begin as soon as I give the orders. Okay. You only need one construction. Construction on your stronghold should begin soon. In a week or so, come speak with me again. Alright, and we should get, like, a journal update when that happens. In the meantime, let's head back out. Let's actually head to Margon, because I'm pretty sure that's close. Oh, God, we went to the practice room again. What are you doing here? What are you doing? Training? Okay, I see.
You have my attention, Outlander.
Oh, look, a sermon. But we can't take it, so I don't want to read it. Unless we can steal it. We may have already read that one. I haven't been keeping track of the numbers. anyways, we'll head out to Margon and head into the Foyda, the Foyada, the lava trail. And we'll look for Shishi. I can scarcely even remember why we're looking for Shishi anymore. Something about, like, we sent someone there to talk with Telvanni people? And they haven't come back? Something like that? And of course, the Telvanni, they're always no good scoundrels. They're always up to no good. Causing trouble. They're very much, they have laws of the West or something. What do you call it when they don't respect the law? They just kind of do their own thing. Frontier justice? Something like that? Yeah. Okay. We can get to Margon using this guy, I think. Directly there. Right? Yep. Great.
Why walk when you can ride?
Absolutely right. Alright, let's wait until it is daytime. That way we can see where we're going, and it's just good for everyone all around. I guess that's... Let's wait one more hour. There. It's a foggy day. Okay. Let's consult our map. Right, I think there's an entrance right next to Margon. To the east. We've actually been here, right? We were, was it escorting or speaking to someone? Oh, yeah. Remember this person? Still trapped in there. Maybe it wasn't them. And look, this is so steep. It looks funky when people are going up it. Okay. Hopefully there is an exit here. And I didn't just walk through here for no good reason. Oh, it seems like I just walked through here for no good reason. That ain't good. Okay, we'll circle around out through this way. No problem. I wonder if there's more buildings in Margon than there are in Alderaan. Seems that way, doesn't it? Like little houses. Personal homes. Okay, great. Trauma roots with no roots to be taken. From here, I think, yeah, that's the ghost fence. You can see it. Look at this person's house. Their house is way out here. Huleen's hut. Oh, wow, there's people out here. What the hell? Are you guys bad? Oh, yes, you are. What the hell? What are you guys doing out here? Just right next to the town. Let's get some restore fatigue going on. There we go. Whoa, take it easy, guys. I don't even know what you're doing all the way out here. Why the guard is, like, letting you out here when you're hostile and you just attack on sight? Gosh, let's get out a better weapon. The fire enchantment is so bad against Dunmer. There we go. Oh, shit. Of course. Okay. Dakin Cunt Arnamu. Aw, oh, jeez. What a name. Okay. And you? Zanat S. Arnuridan. Good God. What a couple of guys. Up to no good. What did they have? This is like that little camp we... Oh, shit, of course. This is like that little camp, though, that we found. Oh, where was it? It was outside of... We'll stash this in here. It's just an expensive shirt. Outside in the Bitter Coast region, wasn't it? And there were a couple of ladies at the Chokeweed Festival, remember? Yeah. Oh, look, it's a Shulk. Don't usually see many of them. They're relatively rare. It's a diseased one. Nice. Some resin. I should have disposed. There we are. Okay, let's get our health back up a little bit. We're gonna need to drink a few of these babies. Man, I bet potions taste awful. Or maybe they taste great. I don't know. I wouldn't want to drink what I put into them. Like some kind of nasty thing. But maybe because it has the restore health, that just makes it... Maybe it tastes like, I don't know. What's something that tastes really good that's a drink? Like some kind of soda. Or maybe you don't like soda. Maybe... Maybe like an orange juice or an apple juice. Or kind of... a vintage wine. Well, no, because there's wine in the game. Alright, so this is another one of the tendrils coming forth from the mountain. Where you're looking down, and sometimes there's lava in here. Of course, that never actually happens in the game. That would be amazing. Oh, man. If Morrowind were made today, they... Oh, shit. Are you guys hostile? Probably. Let's get ready. Just in case. Get my sneak up. It says they're in combat. Okay. Why do you guys always want to fight? Good God. Jesus. So violent. Okay, and you... Wait, is that the same person? No. Asaladamus. Kanat. Narrate Shinilu. And they have a bit of gold. Okay. Drink a couple potions here. Or maybe five of them. Because these ones are so bad. At least we're really reducing our current encumbrance, huh? Okay. Let's double check here what we need to do with Shishi. While exploring a shrine, yeah. Oh, was expecting a report from a house veteran assault on the Telvanni base Shishi. He wants me to go to Shishi and find out what is going on. Shishi is in the Foyada Banidad, northwest of Margon. Right. So it wasn't a diplomatic thing at all, unless you consider, like, consider an assault diplomacy. Hardline diplomacy or something like that. Get this little dude. So we need to keep an eye out for this place. It's probably like a tower or something. Something like that. I'm not too sure what to be on the lookout for. Other than these beautifully stacked rocks. Oh, maybe this is it. Okay. Great. Almost sounded like a Blightstorm was gonna whirl up. We got a rat guarding the outside. Out rat. Hopefully it didn't disease me. Okay, is this it? Shishi? Wow, yeah, that is it. Okay, great. Okay, let's head in. Let's drink a fatigue potion real quick before we do. That way we can have our wits about us. Because he's Telvanni folk. Ooh. Selegil is dead. Some sort of wood elf, it seems. Can we take a torch? No. They're like potted plants or something. They're growing out of the walls. Oh, of course they are. This is Telvanni business. Oh shit. Another dead person. Investigate their corpse. Oh. Hello. I'm guessing you're not hostile to me. Oh shit. I just accidentally tried to pickpocket you. I don't think we've been introduced, Outlander. I'm Anise Remarin. How can I help you? I'm Anise Remarin, warrior and lawman of the Great House Redoran. House Redoran. I belong to House Redoran and serve honorably. Okay. My trade, I'm a warrior. Okay, yeah, sure. Dunmer? Latest rumors? Have you noticed for all of its proclamation? Yeah, these are all things that we've heard and know. Little advice. Yeah, carry potions with you. Secret. Talk to everyone, yeah. Morrowind lore. Worn out weapons and armor work poorly, yeah. Huh, okay. Well, good day to you. I will be sneaking up here to uncover what vile trickery has occurred. Pretty weird that you don't have anything to say. What the hell? Okay. House Redoran. I belong to House Redoran and serve honorably. If these are Telvanni people, it's pretty interesting because they aren't Dunmer. I believe that's a thing about Telvanni, is that they very rarely accept people who are outsiders. A Breton Skull. The Alchemist Formulary. Must have already read that one. Let's see, can we loot these things without them being mad? Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck? Well, they don't seem to mind. Take their bug musk. Take their books. Okay. Pretty weird. I don't know what sort of chain of events that set in motion, but you know what? We've got more than enough opportunity to find it out. Wow, extravagant. Okay, yeah, let's take all that. It's pretty valuable. Cyrodiilic brandy? Jeez, just stumbling all over my words here. Oh, grief. Okay. Let's just drink it. Ancestors of the Dunmer. The Pig Children. Right, this talks about orcs. We can read this, it's very short. No one, not the oldest dark elf of Mount Dagoth-Ur, or the ancient sage of Solitude himself, can recall a time when the orc did not ravage our fair Tamriel. The ancient sage of Solitude? I wonder who that is. Anyways, whatever foul and pestilent Daedra of Oblivion conjured them up could scarcely have created a more constant threat to the well-being of the civilized races of Tamriel than the obnoxious orc. Orcs are thankfully easy to recognize from other humanoids by their size, commonly 40 pertons in height. 40 pertons! Is that like parsecs or something? In height, and 15,000 unjades in weight. Their brutal pig-like features and their stench. They are consistently belligerent, morally grotesque, and intellectually moronic and unclean. By all rights, the civilized races of Tamriel should have been able to purge the land of their blight eras ago, but their ferocity, animal cunning, and curious tribal loyalty have made them inevitable as leeches in a stagnant pool. Tales of orcish barbarity precede written record. When Jestyaga wrote of the Order of Diagnas joining the armies of Daggerfall and Sentinel to hold at bay the wicked orcs in their foul Orsinium fastness and burn aught in cleansing flame. In the first era, 950, she assumed that any reader would be aware of the savagery of the orcs. When the siege was completed 30 years later, after the death of many heroes, including Gaiden, Shinji, and the destruction of Orsinium scattered the orcish survivors throughout the Hrothgarian Mountains, she further wrote, The free peoples rejoiced for what their ancient enemies fell, for what their ancient fell enemies was dispersed into diverse parts. The free peoples rejoiced for that their ancient fell enemy was dispersed into diverse parts. Okay. Obviously, the orcs had been terrorizing the region of the Iliac Bay for at least since the early years of the First Era. Wow, I really stumbled over my fucking talking there. Good God, I don't know what happened. I just, like, instantly became an orc. Oh my gosh. That was what a terrible thing to say. What a bad person. Look at this, there's some money in these. Might come back for, the ingredients. After we have a look around. Okay. So no one here seems to... Oh! You're the one. Okay, let's quick save. Are you the one? Shishi report. Oh, of course. Here, take the report. Your journal has been updated. Shishi report has been added to your inventory. Okay. Can I read it? Can I read the report? Yeah, I can. As instructed, a party of five entered the Velothi Tower of Shishi. Five Telvanni sorcerers fell, and the tower is now ours. But we have suffered heavy losses. We will hold Shishi as long as we can and await your orders. From Barama Selas. Okay. But what did that skull do? Oh. A secret Shishi door. Well, I'm pretty curious as to what's in here. Let's investigate.
Whoa! God! Seven hells, Ned! Oh my God! That really scared me! What is this guy doing down here? Did they lock him down here? He's like casting all sorts of garbage on me too. Faves Andas. Yeah, Faves. Okay. Good God, man. That was terrifying.
Okay. Overview of Gods and Worship. He was just reading about this shit. Apparently. Oh, my grief wore off. Don't worry. We can drink potions. Because we need some health back anyways. There. Take the money. Rue brush. Bunch of useful things. Oh, marshmallow. That's very good. Okay. That was weird. I don't know why that guy was down there. Hey, you know, there's a guy down there. I killed him. I don't know what the hell that was about, but he was down there. Let's go this way and see what's going on. Another dead person. There's a lot more than five dead people, huh? I haven't actually been counting, but it seems like there's way more than five. Let's see. Get this going. Pop open the lock. Got it in one. And it's a crap item. Huh. Closet full of garbage. Yep. Okay. Well, that's pretty weird. I guess we're heading back to Margon then. Let's quick save and put on our speedy boots. That way we can get there super fast. Shouldn't be anything to slow us down here in the Foyada. We can, how should we get to Alt-Velothi? I guess we need to go to Nissus, don't we? Ooh, you know what? Let's try one of our new abilities. MCV Intervention. Right? That's a good idea. Let's actually wait a bit. I can't actually wait, yeah. That would level me, which I don't want to do. Let's just drink a potion. I got so many. Nope. There we are. Oh, we're in Aldrune. Okay, that's fine. Let's put on our boots again. Actually, let's sell some stuff real quick. Let's see. Where is the general merchant? Oh. That was easy. We'll sell our clothing that we picked up in there.
I've special prices just for you today.
Okay. Expensive, expensive. Extravagant. I'm just keeping exquisite stuff. Okay. That should be fine. Oh, we can sell our books as well. Okay, that's pretty good. Oh, Sun's Dawn. Get rid of that. Ooh, we may have sold him way too much. Let's buy these back. There we go. Do you have anything I want, though? Restore health. Sure, why not? They aren't the best, but hey. That's all we got. Bump up the price a bit. Here we are. Cool. Now let's head over back to Thaldan Virith. Gosh, what was that guy doing in there? I don't know, pretty suspicious. Whole bunch of dead people. Maybe they were the Telvanni people. You know, maybe there was some sort of illusion. Some sort of foul illusion. Go to Nissus.
Why walk when you can ride?
Alright, let's pop on the boots. Let's see, we gotta head out this way. Really sucks having to walk all the way to freaking, whatever this place is. Gosh, what is this place called? Tel-Arun? Was that the name of it? Aldvalathi. Tel-Arun? Where is Tel-Arun?
Speak quickly.
I don't know why I was thinking Tel-Arun. My god. I don't know about you, but it is like... It is extremely hot where I am at the moment. And it's not even summer. Good god. How awful. We're just being attacked by cliff racers here. Trying to get our speed on. But just not fast enough. Oh gosh, I almost missed the bridge. There we are. We're on the bridge. I think that was an elit. You know how there's always an elit down there? What the hell? What do you think that elit's doing down there? Maybe that's where they mate. Under the bridge. You know, like how some people, like, in real life, we go to, like, I don't know, waterfronts? By the river? That's like an old stereotype. Banging down by the river? That's something people like to do. Okay. Good god. If we had a mark and recall spell, this wouldn't be so painful. But unfortunately, we do not. Should really consider getting one. I'm not sure what my alteration is at, but hey. Ooh, maybe we'll set our mark at our house once we get one. Once our manor is complete. That way, if we need to stash a whole bunch of stuff, we've got a good place for it. Okay. Thank god, we're finally here. Phew! I've got the report. Yes. Yep, here it is. Yes, this is the report I wanted. What was that? You also found a Telvanni wizard hiding there? Good work, Lyle. Maybe now the Telvanni will give up their claims to Shishi. Oh, was I supposed to speak to someone in there about that? Well, shit. I mean, I guess, you know, what's done is done. Okay, what's next? Duties. I don't have any more duties for you. Like I said, it's quiet out here in Aldvalathi. Check with Naminda and Aldrun, or Feral Ratheran and Vivek. Okay. That's fair enough. Let's head on out to, Aldrun, maybe. We are in Nissus. Still got our, Daedric War Axe. We'll fast travel with the old Silt Strider. Maybe that person, that Naminda recommended us to will be able to take us. We could maybe get advancement. Now that we have our block up higher. Because we did do a lot of block training. Head on down to Aldrun.
Where would you like to go?
Gosh, a lot of traveling this time around, huh? Good lord. Maybe that's what most of Morrowind is when you think about it. Traveling. Nice traveling around, though. Pretty into that. Okay. Let's see. It was, one of the dudes in these manors, wasn't it? Maybe they'll advance us. Was it, let's check the names. No, Serethi Manor, I think it was. The dude who we helped out with his son, who was inside there. Inside that other manor. Having some infighting going on. Okay. Advancement. You have an excellent reputation, but you do not meet our requirements. Well, shit. Maybe my block skill isn't high enough after all. Okay, duties. You have, my son, and I am grateful, but there is another favor I would ask of you. Varver Serethi has been accused of the foul murder of Braylon Carveran. Uh-oh. Braylon Carveran was one of Varver Serethi's friends. I cannot believe that my son would do such a thing, but the evidence is persuasive. I would start by speaking with my son about Braylon Carveran. He is in this room in the guard's quarters. In the guard quarters, okay?
What an unexpected surprise.
Is there something I can do for you?
Let's head over to the guard quarters. Huh. I wonder what's behind there. You know what? Let's see if we can't pick this. We've got plenty of lockpicks. Oh, too complex. Fair enough. Alright, let's find his son. Hopefully he put a shirt on. He was shirtless, right? I'm not mistaken in that. Lots of valuable stuff here. Wow, a whole lot of... Look, another Sermon of Vivek. Oh! Let's read this one. Let me take a drink real quick. Like I said, it's really hot here. The 36 Lessons of Vivek, Sermon 17. I am an atlas of smoke. With this, Vivek become greater than he had been. These were the days of Resdania, when Kymer and Dwemer lived under the wise and benevolent rule of the Almsivi and their champion, the Hortator. Seek me without effort, for I take many shapes. The Hortator was still trying to subdue the heavens with an axe. He was thrown out of the library of the sun by the power of Magnus. Vivek found him in a grub field outside the swamps of the Dishan Plain. They walked for a span in silence, for Nerevar had been humbled, and Vivek still had mercy in his hand. Soon, they were walking across the eastern sea to the land of snakes and snow demons. Vivek wanted to show the Hortator the fighting styles of the foreign tongues. They learned the idiom stroke from the pillow book of the Teski King, the Seishi King. It is shaped like the insight of this page. The Seishi serpents vowed to have their vengeance on the West at least 3 times. Huh. Is that Akavir they're talking about? They walked farther and saw the spiked waters at the edge of the map. Here, the spirit of limitation gifted them with a spoke and blade, and bade them find the rest of the wheel. The Hortator said, "The edge of the world is made of swords." Vivek corrected him. "They are the bottom row of the world's teeth." They walked to the north to the Elder Wood and found nothing but frozen bearded kings. They came to the west, where the black men dwelt. For a year, they studied under their sword saints, and then for another, Vivek taught them the virtue of the little reward. Vivek chose a king for a wife, and made another race of monsters, which ended up destroying the West completely. To a warrior chief, Vivek said, "We must not act and speak as if asleep."
What?
Nerevar wondered if there was anything to learn in the South, but Vivek remained silent and only led them back to Red Mountain. Are they talking about Black Marsh? Because they enslaved everyone? They returned back to Red Mountain. "Here," Vivek said, "is the last of the last. Within it, the Sharmat waits." But they both knew that the time was not ready to contest the Sharmat, and so they engaged in combat with each other. Vivek marked the Hortator in this way for all of the Velothi to see. He sealed the wound with the blessing of Ayem Azura. At the end of the battle, the Hortator found that he had gathered 7 more spokes. He attempted to attach them and form a staff, but Vivek would not let him, saying, "It is not the time for that." Nerevar said, "Where did I find these?" Vivek said that they had collected them from around the world, though some had come invisibly. "I am the wheel," he said, and took that shape. Before the emptiness at the center could live too long, Nerevar put in the spokes. The ending of the words is Almsivi.
What the hell?
Vivek turned into a wheel? They went around to different places and found people and... the black men? What? Is that talking about, the Redguard folks? Or is it further west, a continent west of Tamriel? Like, the Red Guards are descended from. And then what's to the north? The Elder Wood? Like, Skyrim has woods, and they are frozen bearded kings, but I don't think they have Elder Wood. I don't know about that. Is it something further north from Tamriel? Because they went so far east that they went to Akavir with snake people. I have no idea. And they just completely disregarded the, whatever was south. Well, Nerevar didn't, but Vivek did. Oh, let's steal this. Steal this freaking trippy-ass book. Bunch of good stuff in here. Probably worth taking if I weren't so encumbered. We will be back for that. Oh, look at all this. Whole bunch of weapons. Free weapons. Gosh. Oh, here he is.
You have my attention.
Oh, what the fuck? He's got a suspicious ash statue. Okay, Varver Sarethi. I'm sorry, I'm not feeling well. What can I do for you? Let's ask about Braylon. I didn't kill him. He was my closest friend. The guards found me near his body, but I don't remember anything that happened that night. Sometimes, though, I have bad dreams. bad dreams?
Sometimes I kill Braylon Carveren in my dreams. It's horrible. But that doesn't mean I killed him, does it? I was having bad dreams before Braylon Braylon died. About the time I got that ash statue. Ooh, it's right over there. Maybe if you take it away, the bad dreams will stop. I didn't kill him. He was my closest friend's. Bad dreams. Yep. Okay. Let's take the statue. Ooh, and we have one of these. Have we had any bad dreams? I don't think so. Ash statue? I was having bad dreams even before Braylon Carveren died. It seems like they started... Okay. When I got that ash statue, maybe if you take the statue away, the dreams will stop. Maybe I should talk to one of the priests at the temple. Okay. So now we have an ash statue. Let's go... Well, another one. A suspicious one. Right? Yeah, a suspicious one. Let's go speak with his father.
You'll bring me good fortune. How may I be of service?
Okay. Ash statue. This ash statue troubles me. I would have you speak with someone at the temple about the statue. Perhaps Loro Serrano would know more of it. Alright, let's go talk to Loro Serrano's. Ooh, the ash statue. Very suspicious, as it says when you look at the item. Just jump past these guys. Too slow. I'd like to join the temple, actually, you know? Not right now, but in due time. I quite like their pilgrimage business. It's pretty fun. Being as one of my favorite parts of this is running around and exploring all that. Okay. Is it you? No. What about over here? No. One of you. There you are. Okay. Let's ask about the ash statue. You have the statue? Give it to me, and I will see if I can clear Varver's name for the murder of Braylon Carveren. You found an ash statue in Varver Sarethi's room. Give me the ash statue so that I may examine it more carefully. Give him the statue. Thank you, Lyle. Yes, I can see there is some kind of conjuration enchantment on this statue. I believe this statue influenced Varver Sarethi in some manner, causing him to kill his friend, Braylon Carveren. He may still be under the influence of this statue. Tell Varver to come and speak with me. When I'm sure that he is no longer influenced by the statue, I will have him cleared of Braylon Carveren's murder. Oh, man. So, since I have a statue with me, I've had it since very early on. Maybe I've just... As I go from town to town, I've just been murdering people. I mean, I have been murdering people, but like, innocent people that I have no reason to murder. Maybe I feel compelled to murder someone right now, like this guy! This lady! No. Okay. Let's go and speak with, the family. Because apparently he did kill him. Absolutely killed him. Because of the dark sway of the statue.
Hello, with virtue.
My god.
Walk with virtue.
It's very much like a horror movie, you know? I want to say there was a horror movie very similar to that, where they had like a new item within the house. Ooh, it's a haunted thing.
It's making us kill each other.
You have my
very tropey.
Three blessings to you, Outlander.
Okay.
This is a
Braylon,
pleasure.
Thank you, Lyle. I understand that my son's name will be cleared when he has been purged of the ash statue's influence. I knew my son would never murder his friend,
But I understand this statue influenced him in some way. While he's very accepting of that. Okay, sure. Can I get more duties? Oh, look! Andres Norano, a Hlalu noble, claims that Archmagister Bolvin Venom is guilty of certain indiscretions with the wife of another counselor. While I do not approve of all the Archmaster does, as a councilman of House Redoran, I cannot let this accusation stand. I want you to stop Andres Narano's slanders. Alright, slanders. The slander is being spread by Andres Narano. Track him down and demand that he withdraw his slander. If he refuses, challenge him to a duel. But do not shame House Redoran by murdering him.
Sir, you must stop your slanders, or I will duel you!
What? The duel is an honorable tradition dating back at least to the founding of Resdane. Each party to the duel makes an agreement as to the compensation that will be given to the winner. The loser is legally bound to this agreement. Most duels are fought until one party admits defeat or falls in battle. The duel to the death is less common and only ends when one party is dead. The winner of a duel may take what he wants of the loser's possessions, but some consider this dishonorable.
There is no honor in it.
Alright, let's talk about Andres Narano. Zahalalu is a Hlalu noble who lives in Belmora. Go there and stop his slanders about Bolvin Venom. He's a strong leader. Right, he's the leader that is up there and seems kind of like a doucher. Okay, before we call this episode, this video, we need to go and speak with his son. See if he has any extra things to say, now that we've uncovered that he is, in fact, the murderer! Okay, Varver. The Ash statue. I couldn't remember before, but now I know where I got the Ash statue. Or the statue. I got it from Galtus Govron at the Rat in the Pot. Ooh, Galtus Govron.
I suppose there's no harm in talking. What can I do for
Actually, let's go do that. Because I might forget to do it next time. Also, let's steal a Sujama. Do I have room? I do. I stole the grief too. Don't tell anyone. Okay. So we need to head over to the Rat in the Pot. That's Thieves Guild territory. Not normally Thieves Guild way to, murder.
Something I can do for you. Have my attention after. Surprise. Please go ahead.
Can we actually just jump this? Ooh, man, that's maybe a bad idea. Oh, we did it. Okay, Rat in the Pot. I'm ready. I'm ready to uncover this dark plot. It's interesting that, you know, we didn't need to do this part of the quest to advance to the next one. This is all optional stuff, because we figured out the murder. All this is just extra things that we do for his son. Okay. Where is this person that we're looking for? Wait, is this the guy?
Sarah.
No. What was the person's name? Galtus Govron. Okay. Galtus, oh, no. Oh, yes, of course. Look at
How
you.
May I help you?
I'm fine, thank you. What can I do for you? You always know someone's very suspicious when,
when all they're selling are ash statues!
No. I mean, that is very suspicious. But, when they have very few lines that you can ask them about.
Oh, he's so pissed! What?
Ash statue?
How could you? No. Never mind. I'll just have to take care of this right now. Oh, shit. How could I look at his statues? God, I'm such an Enwa looking at his statues!
Oh gosh, let's equip our bound dagger so we can ice this fool. Okay, he's got a silver dagger.
How could you make fun of my statue collection, you bastard? How could you?
Oh, look, his note. Here is another crate of statues. These are to be placed here in Aldrun. Place the statues quickly and wisely. Destroy this note. Do not disappoint me again. Hanare. Okay. You've got two daggers as well on you. How many daggers does a guy need? Alright, let's take some of these statues. Put them here on the floor. You know, put some of these torches here on the floor. These daggers too. You know, just so I know next time I come through here. I mean, that looks pretty bad, but hey. Okay. So, who does it mention? Hanare. Is there anyone here who might know about Hanare? No? What about you, barkeep? No. Okay. Maybe Hanare has a home here. Let's see, do you? Hanare. Ah, there we are. Hanare Asut Lanipal. Let's go say hello and see what sort of foul, horrific thing we'll uncover. Now, I actually do remember this quest line. But, you know, for your sake, let's keep the mystery alive. Oh, it's Hanare! Oh, well, she seems lovely. She doesn't seem like, you know, nothing awful's going on here at all. What's going on? What do you want? Oh, some training. Oh, see, she gives training, too. Look at this. Look, we'll quick save here. And ask her about the ash statue. Last time we asked someone about an ash statue, they attacked us.
There is no escape!
Wow, okay. What? No! What did you... Damn! My statue collection! Jesus! Oh my gosh, she's quite the fighter. Oh my gosh, she's really staggering us. And we can't even equip stuff. Let's bring out our good weapon. Gosh! You asshole! Eat a butt! Oh, you can kinda... Oh my god! She has no thighs! What the fuck? No wonder. This explains everything. Oh, you know what? Let's try and get training from her, actually. Let's try that. Let's quick load and try and get training from her, and maybe we can get money off of her corpse.
Speak quickly, Outlander.
Is that not a good idea, or what? Okay. Let's try... Light armor. Let's try light armor. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, and now we will kill her, and bam, it's the greatest discount of all. Free. Right?
You fetch her! We spent so much time training together! How dare you!
Oh shit, she took all the money! No! Her final act against us! Shit! What an asshole! Alright, we can't permit that. It was just a test, you know, it was an alternate universe. We were just figuring it out. Seeing if we could get some money. Alright, it's time for you to die. Again, a third time. Yeah, not so easy when you're the one getting hit a whole lot, huh?
Okay. So she doesn't have a note. Did our journal update? Hanarei Asut Lanipal attacked me when I asked about the ash statues. Okay. Let's take this. This is good. This is pretty good. Salt rice, I'll take it. Running out of room. Ooh, a lot of salt rice. A whole lot more. And I'm over encumbered. Shit. Shit on it. Let's just drink something, huh? There. That's fine. Okay. Let's see. What's in your chest? Oh, just a little bit of money. I'm down with that, though. Okay. Whole bunch of good stuff in here. Oh shit, I almost hurt myself by opening this trap door. Okay, let's use up a probe, hopefully, because, man, they weigh a lot. We'll be able to find her dark secret. Her foul dungeon where she keeps all of her, ill-gotten gains and dead people. Who she has people murder. Her conjuration station. Holy shit, it is very red! Red room, man! Red rum, red room! All that good stuff. Alright. Oh shit. That's right! She's pretty fucked up. She does some fucked up shit, man. She's into some kinky shit! Look! She's got, like, meats. Some corpus meat. She's got a freaky thing here. Oh, what's it about? She's got crates full of statues. Oh my god. And money, too. The greatest evil of all. But I love it so much. Damn. Okay. I really do want all this money. So, our journal hasn't really updated. We don't really have a lead on who to report this to. But, we've got a few people that we can talk to about this pretty messed up situation. Pretty scary. Coming down here, there's just like, oh my god, what other houses around could have dark secrets within? Who knows? Anyways, when next we come back, we will investigate leads regarding this. We will see who we can talk to, and if there's no one, well, we will continue on this new quest that we have to, talk to Andres Nerano. Probably duel him. Probably gonna need to duel him. We could raise our disposition with that person and, maybe get a more diplomatic resolution. We'll see. Oh, and I have a level in the chamber. Wow, two levels in the chamber, apparently. So I will actually do training. I'll get both of those levels. If you're the type who's interested in those sorts of things, here's a look at my stats. When next you see me, it'll be a little bit different. I'll spend some money. All right, that ought to do it. Peace.